Good morning, student. In this session, we will take the design of boat subjected to eccentric loading. We will take first case, load acting. This is the load. Load acting parallel to the axis of boats. These are the boats. This is the model of bracket. Here holes are provided to insert the bolt. Here in the hole, bolts are inserted. Here load is applied. Here shaft is there. In this hole, shaft is inserted. So load is coming here. So the bolts inserted here are subjected for eccentric loading. This is the direction of load, which is parallel to the axis of bolts. This is the model. Bracket is used to support the shaft, and with the help of bolts, this is attached to roof. Now we will design the bolts. Load is applied here. W load is applied. W is the total load acting at a distance L from the edge AA. This is edge AA. The distance is L, capital L, at acting at, this is the edge. This is the, looking from the top, this is the edge AA. L1 is the distance of bolts in row 1 from edge AA. In the row 1, two bolts are there. Here row 1 is there at a distance L1 from the edge AA. L2 is the distance. L2 is the distance of bolts in the row 2. This is row 2. In the row 2 from edge AA. This is the edge A. This distance is L2. WT1 is the direct tensile load. WT2 is the tensile load on each bolt at distance L2. And small w is the load on each bolt per unit length. Each bolt here is subjected for tensile load and bending load due to eccentric loading. Now first we will find out the tensile load or direct tensile load on each bolt. Now each bolt is subjected to direct tensile load WT1. That is equal to total load upon number of bolts. Total number of bolts are 4. Hence, WT1 is equal to W upon 4, where N is the number of bolts. That is equal to 4. W tends to rotate the bracket. Here, load is there. This load, eccentric loading, tends to rotate the bracket like this. About this tilting edge. This is the tilting edge. So W tends to rotate the bracket about the tilting edge AA. This is the tilting edge. Let small w be the load on each bolt per unit length. Means this load, this is the load on each bolt which changes with the length. Due to turning effect of bracket, and W1 and W2 be the loads on each of bolts at a distance L1 and L2 from tilting edge AA. Therefore, load on each bolt at distance L1. At distance L1, W1 equal to W into L1. This is the load at distance L1. And moment of this load about tilting edge is given by load into distance. The distance is L1 and load is W into L1. This is the moment of one bolt. Now there are two bolts. So the moment of load about the tilting edge is given by 2 into W into L1 square. That is 2 into W into L1 square. Similarly, load on each bolt at distance एल टू डब्ल्यू टू इक्वल टू स्मॉल डब्ल्यू इन टू एल टू एंड मोमेंट ऑफ दिस लोड अबाउट द टिल्टिंग एज इज इक्वल टू लोड इन टू डिस्टेंस. सो लोड इज डब्ल्यू इन टू एल टू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एल टू. एज इन द रो टू बोल्ट्स आर देयर सो टोटल मोमेंट ऑफ दिस लोड अबाउट द टिल्टिंग एज इज गिवन बाय टू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डब्ल्यू इन टू एल वन स्क्वेयर. नाउ टोटल मोमेंट ऑफ लोड ऑन फोर बोल्ट्स अबाउट द टिल्टिंग एज इज गिवन बाय टू इंटू डब्ल्यू एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस टू इंटू डब्ल्यू एल टू स्क्वेयर. हियर वी हैव मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टू बिकॉज इन द रो टू बोल्ट्स आर देयर. हियर वी हैव मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टू बिकॉज टू बोल्ट्स आर देयर. सो टेकिंग टू डब्ल्यू कॉमन टू डब्ल्यू इन द ब्रैकेट एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस एल टू स्क्वेयर. ऑल्सो मोमेंट ड्यू टू लोड डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू इन टू एल. नाउ दिस इज द टोटल लोड डब्ल्यू एक्टिंग एट डिस्टेंस एल. सो इट विल ट्राई टू रोटेट इन क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शंस. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस मोमेंट इज डब्ल्यू इन टू एल. सो इक्वेटिंग थ्री एंड फोर वी हैव डब्ल्यू एल इक्वल टू टू इन टू डब्ल्यू इन द ब्रैकेट एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस एल टू स्क्वेयर. फ्रॉम दिस वी विल फाइंड आउट द स्मॉल डब्ल्यू लोड ऑन ईच बोल्ट पर यूनिट लेंथ दैट इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू इन टू एल अपॉन टू इन द ब्रैकेट एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस एल टू स्क्वेयर. Now, most heavily loaded bolts are those which are situated at greatest distance from the edge. Most heavily loaded, the here L1 bolts are at distance L1 and here bolts are at a distance L2. So, at the farthest distance, bolt will be heavily loaded. Hence, bolts at a distance L2 are most heavily loaded bolts. Therefore, tensile load on each bolt at distance L2, that is WT2 is equal to W2 is equal to small w into L2. Putting the value of small w from here, we will have this equation WT2 is equal to w, capital W into L multiplied by L2 divided by 2 in the bracket L1 square plus L2 square. Now total load on each bolt that is equal to WT, that will be the summation of this plus this WT1 plus WT2. Considering tensile failure of the bolt, this is the total load coming on each bolt. So from the strength equation, sigma T is equal to total load on bolt upon resisting area in tension, that is equal to sigma T is equal to WT upon pi by 4 DC square. From this equation, we can find out the core diameter of the bolt. So this is the design of bolt for eccentric loading in the case when the load is acting parallel to the axis of bolts. Thank you very much. We'll meet in next session.